see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself.
I visit my grandma every weekend.
I talk on the phone with my grandparents at least once a week because they live in another state.
I think teenagers and elderly are both at the ends of the spectrum, so we both have stereotypes about ourselves, whether negative or positive. I think old people are really slow. Whenever you're driving and you're behind someone really slow, you go to pass them and you look over, and they're always old, I swear.
I feel like old people, like you, they have like more knowledge, I guess, and they have like more experience and things like that. But then at the same time, when it comes to like using like technology or like more modern things, like maybe they're not as good as that. And in that sense, maybe they're not as wise or like up to date. So I feel like they have a lot more like experience in like different situations, whether it's like working or like family or like that types of things. So if you ever have any problems, you can kind of look to them for advice and kind of trust their answers and like experiences that they've had, and they're able to like relate it to problems that you have.
Based on the articles we researched, common misconceptions and stereotypes influence the interactions between young adults and the elderly. The lack of communication promotes these common stereotypes and negative perceptions of interactions because young adults do not feel they have the accessibility to interact with the elderly. As stated in the articles, misconceptions include the elderly being too critical of young adults and young adults communicating with the elderly as if they are disabled. For example, talking really slowly and loudly. This is part of communication accommodation theory, as a negative aspect due to the intentions of the slow and loud speech. In this project, we intended to bridge the gap of non-communication between the elderly and young adults through verbal and written communication. By giving both generations access to each other, interactions can turn into a positive experience and stereotypes can be diminished. To accomplish this communication, high school students made the written cards. We presented the cards to the elderly, interacted with the elderly, and witnessed younger generations playing music to communicate with the elderly.
The magic spell you cast, this is love beyond rose. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see love beyond rose. When press me to your heart, and in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Everyday words seems to turn into love song. Give your heart and
really?
It was really wonderful. It was nice. My idea of interacting in general changed as I left because I realized that you do have to interact more one-on-one and be more in tune and accommodate according to each individual person that you're interacting with. It's not so general. It's definitely more catered and individualized, but it was really wonderful. It was nice. It was good just to communicate, interact, and to extend a little bit of autumn and fall joy. So it was nice.
My perception has definitely changed from this experience. For the simple fact that before interacting with them and spending time with more elderly outside of my family, it wasn't necessarily a positive perception because I kind of viewed them as more of like a, not necessarily a burden, that would be a really negative word to use or a heavy word to use, but it was definitely not as capable as younger people were.
Yes, I think elderly people are really special and a lot of times we forget that they're around, and for the fact that as much as we all want attention, they also need their little bit of attention themselves. And for us to go out and pass out our little cards, I think that it brightened their day a little bit more. So I would definitely do it again.
I would say overall, I think I've learned that I think it's good to interact with the elderly, and it definitely brings joy to their day, if that's the right word, and definitely you see the smiles on their faces, and you get to see that, you know, they don't have as many visitors very often, and to come back and to give them that is definitely something that is easy and something that everyone can do.
Based on our interactions, our perceptions have changed about the elderly, and through praxis, we are able to put the communication accommodation theory into practice.